So should Akbaruddin Owaisi apologize? Joining us now, his brother Asaduddin Owaisi, MP of the MIM. Thank you very much for speaking to us. Mr. Owaisi, by now, lakhs of people across the country have heard the comments of your brother. Three sections under the IPC, including attempt to wage war against the government of India, have been slapped against Akbar. You can debate, sir, the merits of the case, but can you deny that he was trying to hurt people of other religions?
Look, I have been consistently saying that two criminal cases have been booked against him, against the alleged hate speech which he has made.
Yes.
I would please request you that hold your horses. You are asking me a question from a TV studio and I am sitting in Hyderabad. Please don't go ahead and convict him. Let the courts of law take the whole process of law, will take its turn.
Sir, no one is convicting him over here, sir.
Will be able to present his case in the courts of law.
Shooting the messenger is a favorite pastime of politicians. All I'm trying to ask you, sir, is this. Let's not get into, it'll be a court and a judge who will decide what happens to your brother. But shouldn't he have avoided some of the remarks that he made? It's a simple question I'm asking you.
No. See, that there is, you're asking me a question and you're answering me also.
No, sir, I'm not. I'm waiting for your answer.
No. That is why I am requesting you.
Yes.
That the cases have been booked against him. Whether he has violated the sections which have been imposed or not, that the courts of law will decide.
But what about...
I am not an expert of law. You're not an expert in law.
Right. But
let the courts decide, let the person who has been accused for this crime, he will get an answer, he will be able to answer in the court, away from all these media scrutiny where unfortunately electronic media have mobbed and lynched Akbar Owaisi, and you have already convicted him.
No, sir.
I am sure the court of law will decide.
It's not our place to convict, and we on this channel have not convicted anyone. I'm just asking you, do you believe, then let me ask you, do you believe there is something in his speech for which he should apologize? I'm asking you.
Look, I can pose so many things to you which you will not like when you start this topic of apology. I am saying a criminal case has been booked, Mr. Vishnu Som, and the accused will get all the right, and the government which has imposed the sections will have to prove beyond reasonable doubt.
So in other words, at this stage you stand by your brother.
That is the best place to decide.
Yes, it is the best place to decide. And we aren't going to question whichever way the court decides. That's not for you to do and not for us to do. I am merely asking you, as an MIM leader and as the brother of Akbar Owaisi, to answer this question. Is there anything that he has said which you feel he should not have said? That you feel he should apologize for?
As far as his speech is concerned, please understand that a case has been booked on him. Let us not go into the merits or demerits or good or bad or very violated. The courts are there for it to decide.
We are not going into
and
the merits.
And when you talk about apology...
We are not going into the merits, sir. Again, the court will decide that. I am asking you as his brother. Do you stand by everything that he said? It's a simple question, sir.
What?
Yes or no?
Do I stand by it and everything? I stand by the right of an accused,
okay,
which the Indian Constitution, which the Indian Penal Code, which the CRPC, which the Indian Evidence Acts provides. And he has the right to answer over there. You and me cannot usurp the right of any person who has been accused. Now that will be decided by the courts of law.
Okay, Mr. Owaisi, let me ask you this. Senior BJP leaders have said Akbar's speech was tantamount to inciting Muslims to revolt against the police and the army, and they say even possibly start a civil war. This is what they've said. How do you respond to what some BJP leaders have said?
No, why are you asking me about BJP? You should have asked him whether the demolition of Babri Masjid, what was that? Whether the genocide in Gujarat, what was that? You should have asked the BJP and you should have asked your fraternity, Mr. Vishnu Som, that they covered a life, they gave a life coverage of a person's funeral who said that Muslims and Islams are a cancer in India.
No, but sir, no, BJP no, is no conveniently speech, forgotten no this. Speech,
let BJ, no, no, no,
no,
I, no, 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 no,
no,
I have the right to answer. I
yes,
cannot,
yes,
no,
yes,
you, either,
means,
no, no, either, either you please tell me what I have to answer, then I'll,
no,
then
no,
I'll
no,
answer
no,
those questions only.
Go ahead and answer.
You are
I'm
not
listening.
In allowing me to, you are not in allowing me. Please go ahead and I'll wait for your question.
No, no, I'm waiting for your answer, sir. You raised a point about Bal Thackeray's procession, and I'm just making the point that hate speeches by him or other leaders have not been carried.
Yes, that is why I'm saying that when there is a movement in India right now, a right movement asking for gender equality, I am also demanding communal equality. You cannot have two different yardsticks. Please understand this, and BJP has no right. I mean, how can BJP question Akbaruddin Owaisi's loyalty to the nation? I can understand other sections, that is debatable, that courts will decide.
Yes.
But you are imposing 121. What is the message that you are sending? Was ever all these persons which I have just mentioned, 121 was imposed on them? I feel the demolition of Babri Masjid and the people who have been accused in 197-198 FIR had waged a war against India, wherein it led not only to demolition but to a huge communal riot in whole of India when innocent people lost life.
No, but that's a separate issue, sir. And the points that you make are extremely valid. And no one is questioning the points you're mentioning at all. But I am only focusing on your brother. But let me ask you this, sir. Since you're not answering the question directly, that's your choice. Let me ask you this. Is he positioning himself as a leader who goes beyond the established political parties, like for example the Congress, as a leader who wants to reach out to an urban, middle class Muslim electorate who perhaps do not have the representation that they actually want? Because his image is of somebody who's suave, well-spoken, has a cosmopolitan background. Is he trying to identify himself as a new age politician among certain people?
First, let me answer you, Mr. Vishnu Som, that I am answering all the questions you are posing to me.
Yes.
I am at liberty to give an answer to your question, but I cannot answer according to what is there in your mind or
no,
what you want me to answer.
I am asking a question. I don't want you to answer
okay,
any other
now,
than what
no,
you want.
Exactly. I will never do that. You have all the right to ask me a question, and I have all the right
to answer, sir.
In the way which I feel is right to answer a question.
Okay.
Now, second question which you have asked me about whether Akbaruddin Owaisi is positioning himself.
Yes.
Please understand that this huge media publicity that was given to this issue, did I demand or did I say? I mean, what is this? After that poor girl's gang rape, And her death continues for 3-4 days, you have, your fraternity had given a huge 24 hours coverage to this issue. Aren't you responsible for giving him such a wild publicity and coverage, and also convicting him in the process and calling him by different names? One BJP General Secretary called him a Deshdrohi, one called him an LET,
yes.
One great TV presenter said that he should be taught a lesson. And now, who is doing this? Don't you think that it is high time that there should be some introspection from electronic media also?
Sir, we aren't doing that on this channel. I'm not saying anything about him. I'm not making any judgments about him. You and I both agree, whatever happens, happens in court. But sir, tell me about the politics of this, sir. A lot of people feel that a lot of this has to do with the politics of the MIM, the areas that you're trying to establish yourself in Andhra Pradesh. That once again, he is trying to position himself in Andhra Pradesh to establish himself in that state in a more prominent manner. And that there is a design in these statements coming out. How would you respond to those?
No, Vishnu Som, I would tell you that if the Andhra Pradesh dictatorial government led by the Chief Minister should hire you as a public prosecutor. You are a very good cross exam. You have a great talent for cross examination. But I am not falling into that trap. Let me tell you one thing to answer your question in a different way.
Yes.
Please, that our struggle is a political struggle. Number one.
Yes.
We are a political party.
Yes.
Our struggle is within the four walls of the Indian Constitution. Our struggle is for political equal representation, equal share in the development.
Yes.
And please, you answer me if I am communal. Why is it that, Mr. Vishnu Som, in the state of Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Maharashtra, which are bordering states, which have 117 Lok Sabha seats, you have only one Muslim member as Lok Sabha member? You take these three states, take the Muslim percentage, and what is the representation in the state assembly? This is what we are addressing. We are asking for equal share in development. I mean, each political party wants to develop itself, and what is wrong? This is what our democracy provides.
So
whether it is right or wrong, the people will decide. If it is against the law, the law will decide.
Okay, let me ask you one final question. This is coming in from our viewers who feel that your brother should either apologize for his remarks or he should be banned from politics. How do you respond to those? That either he apologizes for what he said because it's hurt the sentiments of people, or he should be barred from politics. It's again not my question, it's what people are sending in to us right now.
No, I can give a very answer. I'll answer those people only. Why should I answer you?
Go ahead, answer
them.
I
am saying that he will answer that. The courts will take a decision, and I will answer those people. I will go to the masses and put forward my political message to them. Let the people decide if he is wrong or if he is right. If he is right, the people will elect him. The people will take him forward, and the law is there to decide. When you talk about apology, when you talk about banning from politics, please, you are opening a floodgates argument. I don't want to open that argument. Then you'll say, then I'm going off the track.
Okay.
Have people apologized for the Gujarat riots? Have people apologized for demolition of Babri Masjid? Have people apologized for all the riots which have taken
place? But that doesn't justify any
of
that.
I am saying I believe in rule of law. And no, I am not justifying. I am saying you have a different yardstick. You have a different yardstick.
All right.
Let the law take its own course.
All right, fair enough, Mr.
Let the law decide. If people on their whims and desires, that is not the law.
Okay. All right. We take the point you're making. It has to be decided by a court of law. And that's going to happen one way or the other. But you did not answer that question directly about your personal views and whether he should apologize or not. But that, sir, is entirely your right.
No. Court will decide.
All right,
I
court, will,
answer
court,
what
court
you want.
Will decide. You don't have an opinion. Fair enough, sir. Thank you so much for joining us.